Hello everyone, welcome back to your favorite cat prep channel Quantifiers. So in the DILR set for today, we are going to discuss a very different type of DI. And this is the set in which a lot of people were finding a difficulty in how to read the data. So that is why we picked this kind of set. Okay. Also, before we begin, this our new batch is going to start super soon. So if you are interested in any of our courses, you can contact me anytime. Or for any need or any counseling, you can contact me anytime. 9988656565. Let's move towards the set. So let's see what the set is all about. They say that percentage of 5 students A, B, C, D and E in 3 subjects physics, chemistry and math are represented in the triangular graph above. So yahan pe inki percentage di hui hai. Okay. For a subject, percentage is taken by first moving along the axis from the vertex marked 0 for that subject and stopping at the point where student's percentage in that subject first crosses that particular axis. So this is a tricky part, or this is a point we need to understand. How do we understand this? That let us say mujhe E ka score dekhna hai sare subjects mein. I want to check the score for E in all the subjects. E has physics as well as chemistry as well as math. So let's say maine E ka score math mein dekhna hai. If I want to check the score of E in mathematics, so E ki mathematics ki taraf line kaun se ja rahi hai? This is the first line. This is the first line that is going towards math. This is the second direct line that is going towards the math. Now I need that I should go from 0 to 100. Main 0 is 100 ki taraf move kar raha hu, and the first line I encounter will represent the percentage of E. So E ke math mein kitne percentage hai? 40%. Let's do it for chemistry also. Ab aap dekho, just see that where will you move for chemistry? You have to move from 0 to 100. This is the direction you need to move. Now for chemistry, E से कहां लाइनें जा रही है? One line is going towards this point. One line is going towards this. So which line will intersect first? This line will intersect first. So E's score in chemistry is 30. Let's talk about physics then. Now physics line देखो नीचे है हमारे पास. The line is moving from this to this direction now. And from E there are two points going towards this. This and so the line is moving towards this direction. 0 to 100. And there are two lines, this one and this one. These are the two lines. Since these are the two lines, here the point is 30. Okay, so this needs to be 30. The first point of intersection we need to see, right? This is the basic understanding. So now we have understood how to understand or how to read the data. Now we'll move towards the data set and we will try to answer the question. And since we have understood, I have removed some unnecessary information or removed some redundant information. I know that A, B, C, D, E, these are the 5 people. I know now everything. I just need to plug in the values and I just need to check what is my final result. So one by one, let's start filling the values. Let's start with A. A ka physics mein score. If you have still not understood, I request you to pause it and see. Let's just fill the score for everyone for math. Math, we need to go from here to here. Where is A? A is here. So A is 10 and A is 40. But first is 10, so I will select 10. So math mein A ke score kitna aaya? 10%. Let's talk about B. B ki line ye hai aur wo hai. So yahan pe aaya 20%. Similarly for C. C ki ek line ye hai, ek line ye hai. 80%, the first line. Similarly for other two, this is 30 and 40%. This is 30 and 40%. And also we knew that the total marks are 100, total marks we have are 200. Okay, ye hame diya hua hai that total marks, maximum marks are 200, right? So if these are 200, which means this is 20 marks, 40 marks, 160 marks, 60 marks and 80 marks. So similarly, let's see for chemistry. Now for chemistry, where do I need to move? For chemistry, I need to move this way. And I will see the first line of cutting. So for A, one line is this, one line is this. I will take this one. So for chemistry, it will be 30%. For other person B, it is 40%. For C, it is 10%. D, it is 20%. And for E, it is 30%. E and E are on the same axis. So in the terms of marks, it is 60, 80, 20, 40 and 60. These are in the terms of marks. Okay. Now let's talk about physics. So this is the physics scenario. I have to move from, oh, again, in a posit. I have to move from 0 to 100, which means from this way to this way I have to move. So now let's find out. 0 से 100 आ रहा है आपका, A का स्कोर देखते हैं. A का एक कटिंग यहाँ पे, एक कटिंग यहाँ पे, मैं कहाँ पे लूंगा A? I'll take this one. So A is 60%. So what is for A? A 60% means score is 120. For B it is 40. So score is 80. For C it is 10. So the score is 20. For 50 and then 30. And the score will be 160. So now I have compiled my scores. So the only difficult part in the whole set was this. Okay, an interesting observation. Can I say for any point in the vertex, let's say this point, if I see the lower axis total, and then this lower axis total, and then this lower axis total, 30 plus 50 plus 20, the total is always 100%. This is 20. The total is always 100%. Or I can see, observe from here, 60, 30, 10, 100. 40, 40, 20, 100. So basically, the total marks that are 200 are distributed among these three candidates, always, right? यहीं पे इनके मार्क्स आएगी. डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ही इस तरह से अलाइंड है. व्हेनेवर इट विल बी गिवन टू अस दैट फॉर एनी पॉइंट, पर्टिकुलरली फॉर एनी पॉइंट, आई नीड, लेट्स से आई एम टेकिंग दिस पॉइंट, द लोअर पॉइंट इज 60, द लोअर पॉइंट इज 20, एंड द लोअर पॉइंट इज 20 अगेन. सो 60 प्लस 20 प्लस 20 अगेन 100. फॉर एनी पॉइंट इन साइड द ग्राफ द टोटल इज गोइंग टू बी 100 ऑलवेज. ओके, सो विद दिस नाउ आई विल स्टार्ट सॉल्विंग माई क्वेश्चन. वॉट इज द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन आई हैव? What are the average marks obtained by the students in chemistry? So 60, 140, 160, 200, 260. 260 divided by 5. 52 is the answer. Let's look at the second question. For the second question, P is another student whose marks are marked on one of the inner vertices. किसी भी एक inner vertex पे है. Remember, vertex. It is not in between. It is in one of the inner vertex. क्योंकि ये inner vertex पे है, his average marks per subject are in between. So the range is disappeared. But I know for sure that for any range, the total is going to be 100% or the total is going to be 120, 60, 200, 200, 200. So the total is going to be 200 for any student if his scores are lying on the innermost vertex. So if the total is 200, the average is going to be 200 divided by 3, 66.66. This is what the average will be. Okay. Now, this is also clear to us. Let's think about the other thing. So whatever the range was, that will be the answer. This was 52. Now, it is shown that F is another student whose marks are plotted on the same graph. Many marks obtained by A and F in math are in ratio 2 is 5. 2 is to 5 in math. So if this 2 is 10, 20, 5 is 50. So this is talking about F student. Okay. And marks obtained by C and F in the physics are 2 is to 7. So physics may 2 is to 7. So here it must be 70. Okay. So in chemistry it must be 80 because the total is always constant 200. Total is always constant 200. So this way, if this is 50, this is 70, this must be 80. Now if this is 80, percentage marks will be 80 upon 200 into 100, that is 40% marks. 40% is the net result for this. Okay. Let's look at the last question now. The last question says, X is another student who is the only topper in math. Only topper means undisputed topper. There is no one around him. So in the math, right now the highest percentage is 80. See, for C, 160, 80. So for X to be the topper, X can either have 90% or 100%. X ke paas 90% honge ya fir 100% honge. Which means 180 marks are definitely distributed here. At least 180 marks. Ya 180 honge ya 200 honge. Theek hai? What is the least difference in his mark, in his and D's chemistry marks? D ke chemistry ke marks kitne hai? 40. D ke chemistry ke marks hai 40. Minus X ke chemistry ke marks ko difference least karne. Ab X ke total marks kitne the? टोटल मार्क्स है 200. मैथ में उसके आ सकते हैं 180. अब मुझे क्योंकि डिफरेंस मिनिमाइज करना है, आई वांट टू मिनिमाइज द डिफरेंस, देयरफॉर आई वांट टू मैक्सिमाइज दिस. इफ आई हैव टू मैक्सिमाइज दिस, द ओनली मैक्सिमम वैल्यू आई कैन गिव टू इट इज 20, बिकॉज़ 180 इज द मिनिमम वैल्यू इन मैथ. सो दिस इज 20, देयरफॉर प्रोड्यूसिंग अ डिफरेंस ऑफ 20. सो दिस हैज कंप्लीटेड माय सेट. So now my set is completed, and with this we have finished it. I hope you like the explanation. If you did, please do subscribe to our channel, and our new batch is going to start super soon. Join us. Thank you so much, guys. Have a great day.